Hey everyone, and welcome to Backpack Battles. Today we are taking a look at this upcoming auto battler. I first encountered this game many months ago. I'm unsure when this game was made available to the public for playtesting for the first time, so it could even be a year or two since I saw this for the first time. But ever since then, I've been wanting to try it out for myself. So when the developers contacted me a couple of days ago asking if I'd be interested in trying out their game, I immediately agreed. So a huge thank you to IndieArc for providing me with this opportunity. Backpack Battles is an inventory management auto battler. This means that once we commit to a battle, we have no control until it's over. We need to prepare our backpack beforehand. We do this by buying items such as weapons, armor, and accessories and placing them in our backpack. What's even more important though is how we place these items. Most items have synergies that either receives or gives benefits to other items. The strength of your build is highly dependent on how good you are at maximizing these bonuses. With the latest patch, as of this recording, the Cool update, the game features 4 unique classes, 30 special level up skills and subclasses, over 300 different items, some class specific and some generic that you can find on all classes, a crafting system that allows you to upgrade certain items, sometimes changing them drastically, as well as various cosmetic outfits for each class available for purchase for in-game trophies. It is a PvP game, so you battle other players' builds, getting progressively harder with each round. The game is not run in real time, so in between battles you can take as much time as you want trying to figure out the most optimal placement for your items. Nothing is locked in place, everything can be moved and rearranged, even your backpack. Each round you fight a copy or a ghost, if you will, of another player's build for the current round. At the same time, when you finish a round, your build gets thrown into the build or into the pool as well for another player to potentially come up against. As always, if you want to see more of this game on the channel, watch the video and leave a like. If you're feeling particularly awesome, you can even leave a comment. Without any further ado, let's try Backpack Battles. So I've been playing this for, I think, around like 5 or 6 hours, and I've been having a ton of fun. It is, as you might imagine, a game with loads of replayability. There is a ton of different builds that you can try out to your heart's content, really. I think we are just gonna go ahead and give it a go here. We have 4 classes. We have the Ranger, we have the Pyromancer, we have the Reaper, and we have a Berserker. I don't really know anything about the classes, when they were released or anything like that, if there's plans for new classes or anything to the liking. But we can see up here what they start with, and we have a couple, we have 2 different choices with each of them that and they focus on different things. If we don't like either, or we're just feeling a little bit adventurous, we can do a sack of surprises, which means it's completely random what we're gonna do. I don't know this game that well to do that, so we're not gonna do that today. It is a game that is, I feel, is extremely easy to get into, but it's extremely difficult to master. There is so many things that you can craft, as we'll get into. So let's try and do like a standard run here with the Ranger. First class, Ranger bag. We can see that he starts with 2 leather bags. He has a special Ranger bag as well that makes it so items inside gain 10% critical hit chance plus 3% for each luck. And luck is something that increases accuracy. We already have a lucky clover, so at the start of battle we will already get 1. So that might be something that we can focus on here. We have ranked games, we have unranked games. I don't know the difference. I don't know if there is any difference other than, of course, that the ranked contributes to your current rank. I don't know if this is just I don't think you get any special rewards here, but I don't know. Could be it's just to make it a little bit harder on yourself if you want to challenge. I think unranked you can really get up against anything. It's probably a lot of people just trying out the game and trying to learn, so that's what we are going to be doing today. Okay, and now here we have the shop. He apparently can help you with a lot of stuff if you want to, but I think today we'll just be trying to we'll just be trying to wing it, and I'll explain it as best as I can. We can see our current money down here. We start with 12 gold. We have five items that we can re-roll up here for one. It gets a little bit more expensive. I think after like the third re-roll, it's going to start to cost two, so we still want to be careful. At the moment, we have a wooden sword, and we can see that that little blue line is actually... It means that there's an item here that it is interested in upgrading with. And if we hold Alt, we can get a list of everything this sword can upgrade to. I don't believe it's necessarily any everything it's every recipe it's in. But this is what we can upgrade the sword to. So if this is like... Actually, we can probably see it right here, maybe. I'm not actually sure. It doesn't really matter. Let's see. We could upgrade this to a... What is that? We can actually see it in here, what they're called as well. To a hero sword with two whetstones. It deals extra damage. Start of battle weapons gain plus two damage. Okay, so everything around it, that's the stars around it, gets two damage. I guess we could try and work ourselves towards that. Let's buy that. It also gives the weapon... the whetstone at least, start of battle weapons gets plus one damage. Let's do that, because why not? I think... Let's showcase that this can actually move around. I think we're gonna go for the bow as well. We are a ranger. This is a short bow, and we can see it actually works together with the Lucky Clover for an upgrade. And it's on sale, so why not? I know that this needs two Lucky Clovers to upgrade into... what's it called? Fortune's Hope? Was it something like that? I think it was. Fortuna's Hope. Okay. Which is something we want if we want to go for a Lucky Clover build, or a luck-based build at least, because on hit we have a 70% chance to gain luck. Okay, let's buy the banana as well, because every 5 seconds we heal for 4 and regenerate 1 stamina. So we like to heal. What did this... This purely weapon, so it doesn't really matter where we place this at the moment. We don't really have any other food. Yeah, we can see that the banana gets 10% faster for each food type. Every different food type, I should say, so it doesn't count with bananas. Let's reroll, since we don't want the rest here. I don't think we're going to be going over every single item, otherwise we're going to be here forever. I already think it's going to be kind of a long video, just because it's going to... There's so much to go over if we want to go over everything in detail. So we're gonna explain some things, and we're gonna skip over some others. We do want more space always. So let's reserve this. That means it's not gonna get rerolled. And let's get the garlic here. It gives us armor, and it gives us armor every 4 seconds, and a chance to remove vampirism from our opponent, which heals when they do damage. And since it's food, let's place it next to the banana, so both of these trigger 10% faster. We have zero money left. Let's get into a battle and see what happens. You do have a little bit of a grace period here to cancel if you regret something. And we can just sit back, see how well we do. Looks like we'll be doing okay, but we never know. If you're interested in anything what happened, we won, of course, this one. And we didn't lose it. We have 5 lives. We need to do 10 wins to win the run. We can continue for extra rewards if we want to. But it's worth noting that if you win and take the win, you not only get 10 trophies, you actually get double. So there is a risk to continuing. If you want to see what's going on here, you can hide this. You can show the log, and you can see them quite literally, step by step, what's happening. If you want to really... deep analyze why you lost, for instance, or why you won, or why something happened. I am nowhere near good enough to notice anything at the moment, so we are not going to be doing this too much, if at all, to be honest. But the more experienced players, or if you notice something that you think, this is odd, or what is this item, I would like to actually read this before continuing, you have the option to. Okay, we got 9 gold, our max health increased as well. We do have another short bow here, which is pretty nice. Our stamina usage at the moment is pretty low. Oh, it is actually low, so we could probably afford another bow. Let's do that. That raises it to high, so now we want to be careful with what we do here. This works with a bow as well, I believe. Yes, and we can actually see here, what does that do? That is the Tusk Poker. We have a chance to gain spikes, which returns damage on melee hits. Not necessarily something we are super interested in. Let's get the backpack. That leaves us with one gold. Don't think we're interested in this. We could get the piggy bank, which gives us more gold every time we enter, and maximum health for any other start of battle item that it's next to. It does upgrade with the lucky clover as well. Where is that? Should be in here somewhere, right? Am I blind? It's right there. Lucky picky. It needs two. Okay, start of battle, you gain two clovers. Or two luck. And chance-based effects of the marked items are 15% more likely to trigger. Okay. That honestly might not be too bad. We're gonna need a lot of lucky clovers to upgrade the bows as well, plus the picky. But let's try. Let's reserve this one. It does help other than that as well. Let's save the last gold. We could reroll and reserve some items, but let's save it. I don't know what's tactically the best option here, but we are no experts yet. They have no healing. That's gonna cost them. That's very nice. Two wins. Okay. Well, we have the second whetstone here to upgrade to a hero sword. Honestly, let's do that. So to upgrade it, we need to do a battle with it, and they need to be next to it. So we can see right now it says, when we move this in, it's 1 out of 2, even though we have 2. But they need to be next to it. It's green, 2 out of 2. That means this will upgrade when we are done. Let's get this one. Let's see here. We have start of battle this one. And I think that is not the only one. Let's see if we can't. We should be able to do something here. Let's do that. That means we get 6 maximum health. Let's get this one down here. We want these items to touch the ranger bag, so they get increased crit chance. That might, however, mean that we can't get these two next to each other. I think that's okay for now. We are not like super late into the game, so maybe we'll be okay. And even if we take a loss, we get some life back once in a while. I do like the leather armor for the extra armor at the start of battle. And we do resist some debuffs as well. That is, however, all it does, but it is a nice buffer, especially in the beginning. Let's reserve that. 3 gold, I think, is quite a lot to save, but I think we will, just because this is a big purchase. So let's try it. We'll get 2 more spaces here, because these will merge with our wooden sword. Let's see. They have a lot of health, but they don't have any healing either, so maybe we'll be okay? You never know. Sometimes what looks like a surefire victory can quickly turn, and the other way around as well. There we go. They are now merged into a hero sword. Very nice. So we want this one to touch our bows. I think actually see we get a skill. That's something we get every once in a while. It's very specific once we get. What is this, round 4, 5, something like that? Let's take a look at them in a minute here. Let's do something like this. And we can actually get this one over here. But the food, very nice. And we can keep this piggy right here for a start of battle item. could actually do this because the hero sword also have a start of battle. Yeah, let's do that. And let's see what we get here. We get some just stats. Start of battle, gain 15% maximum health and 10% base stamina regeneration. Always offered in round 4. Yes, round 4. There we go. We also get Mana Mystery. Mana Orbs gain plus 17 random buffs. I've never played with this, so I don't really know what that means. But every 6 seconds we gain 3 mana. And it triggers 20% faster for each, let's go, mana item, mana skill. Then we have Super Spacious. Bags appear more often in the shop and have plus 30% chance to be on sale. And then it says the star items trigger 5% faster for each free green slot. Okay, that's something that's very interesting. Heavy drinking. Every 5 seconds trigger the effect of a random potion. Triggers 25% faster for each distinct potion. This is not something that we can benefit from right now. But this honestly could be interesting in the future once we get some potions going. Triggers 25% faster for each distinct potion. That's going to be a lot of potion drinking. But it is called heavy drinking, of course. Honestly, let's grab that and hope that we get to a little bit of the late game. But it does cost money, but as we that's why I just checked, because I could see we got 14 last time, and that's probably to include this the price for this one, for the skill. We could reroll if we don't want it, but there is some randomness to it, so maybe you don't get anything that's particularly interesting. Okay, we do get ourselves a fanny pack here. Items inside trigger 10% faster, and it's worth noting, as you might have noticed here as well, that they don't have to be completely inside the bag to actually get the benefit from it. So I could place this here, and this bow will get the benefits. As we can see, actually, it triggers 10% faster from the fanny pack, and it gains 10% in critical hit chance from the ranger bag. It just needs to have some part of it inside the bag to benefit from it. And honestly, let's see, we can move this around as well if we want to, by the way. Let's see, I would like one of the bows at least to touch the fanny pack, and it probably will be the sword as well. Well, it will be the sword as well. Let's see, we do something like that. No, we need to remove this one as well. We need to remove this one. We're going completely new here. So we do that. We do that. We do that. And I'd like something like this, possibly. It is not... excuse me. It's not completely perfect. We could do that. You gain no benefit from being over there, because if we do this, then we can actually fit both of these. Not next to each other, but that means we can also get the armor in there. I think I do like that. We don't want any of this, so we can go ahead and reroll. It's a distinct lack of lucky clovers, unfortunately. The healing herbs are nice, because we can actually use these to upgrade the healing potion in the future. And apparently also this chef, a rat chef, I've never had that. Get some regeneration and some, what's it called, empower, which gives bonus damage to weapons. Okay, but well, we are not really a pet build, so we would be using it for the potion. I think we're gonna let it go for now. We have a carrot. Every 3.5 seconds, cleanse one debuff. If you have at least 4 luck, 55% chance to gain empower. Okay. Well, at the moment we don't have 4 luck, but we are trying to build a luck build, so let's hang on to that one. Let's see if we can't find an opponent here. We are up against another ranger. They have managed to find the lucky clovers that we want as well. Doesn't look like they have any healing though, so they are in trouble. Yep, that was, I think, what you call a flawless victory. And that might be the difference, by the way, between the ranked and unranked, that these battles, for those of you that actually play it, they might seem very easy, and maybe they are. We do get a stamina pack, 3 slots, and gain +1 maximum stamina, which is always nice. More stamina is more good. It would be nice if we somehow... Yeah, maybe do something like this, get you down here. And let's see if we can't actually... Yeah, we can get all these to touch each other. So they all buff each other right there, that's actually very nice. There's another banana. They are difficult to say no to, because they also work with a potion that I really like. I would like to find in the future, and you know, healing is always good. Both health and stamina. Can't fit it at the moment, but we will buy it and chuck it in there. Let's see what we can find. Oh my lord. We do get a holy armor, which we could switch out for our leather armor. It's more block, and we do get some regeneration for each other holy item we have, which at this moment is absolutely nothing. But it also cleanses to poison every once in a while. That might honestly not be too bad. We also have a hungry blade. I gotta say, at the moment, our luck build is not working out too well. What can you upgrade with? 2 more whetstones. Wow. What do you go into then? You go into... That's this one. Hero Longsword. Okay. Okay, start of battle weapons gain 4 damage. You know what? Let's... maybe we're just gonna do some more basic weapons here. Let's save that. Or reserve that at least. This is a big purchase. We're gonna get 10 gold, so we're not gonna be able to afford this one. We would have to sell stuff, and we don't want to sell this at the moment. We'll reserve it, so it might be for the round after this. Okay. Let's see how this is gonna go. Seems like at the moment we have a decent enough build. But as always, it's very dependent on what we are up against. They do have some healing, they do also have a potion. But it still looks like maybe we'll be okay here. Fatigue damage will set in soon. That's something that happens when it goes on for a while. It just gives damage to everyone. So at some point, you know, someone will die, even if we could out-heal each other. Ooh, we get a potion belt. Specifically, obviously, for potions. First potion inside consumed, gain a random buff. And 4 potions inside consumed, cleanse 8 debuffs, which is very nice. Also get a bow and arrow. Weapon hits gain +1 damage up to 7. Again, it can be upgraded with the Lucky Clover, but I believe these recipes are kind of the same. We have, you know, poisoned with the small bow, poisoned with the bigger bow. Lucky Clover with the small bow, Lucky Clover with the bigger bow, yeah. So that's Fortuna's Grace versus Fortuna's Hope. They do different things though. Start of battle gain 3 clovers or 3 luck, and weapon crits attack twice on the next attack. Did we have something with crit? I can't remember. Was it the bag? Yeah. Feel like we are going to be reserving a lot of items here. Grab that, or reserve it, grab this one for the future, and we'll grab this one. That means we could move you out, we could move you back, you'll still get bonuses, and we could get the bonuses from the whetstone on these guys. Yeah, let's do that. Can we... I don't think we can utilize these... 4 spots we have around here to get in the banana. I mean, we could do this. Gain 2 maximum health for each. You know what? I don't necessarily think we care too much about that. So let's just get this one in here. Can we maybe rearrange this a bit so it works differently? I don't think we can. Two, three, two, and one. That's probably the best we can do. It's better than before. Let's say we are good to go. We get 11 gold, so we could get the armor next time, which means we could sell this one and probably get the bow as well, maybe? Let's see. You have some healing. You have a lot of health, sir. We could be in some trouble here, and I think we are. Yep, that's gonna be our first loss. That's okay. We still advance to the next round. I believe we still get the same gold. So, you know, nothing other than you getting a loss really changes the outcome of anything else. Okay. Yeah, I think that is the plan. We're gonna get this one. Yoink. Sell this one for 4. That just exactly does not give us enough to get the bow and arrow here. It's okay, because we actually don't really have space for it at the moment yet, so a bag would be nice. We have another bow and arrow. I think one will do, if I'm being honest here. We do have a gin lamp. That could also help us with our luck. The downside of it is that we gain either luck, spikes, or mana, depending on what we have the least of. And since we do have Lucky Clover already and are trying to get other things that give us luck, don't think this is the right call for us. Let's do another reroll. There is a bag and a potion. That's all the good stuff. Stone skin potion. 45 block reached. Consume this and convert 15 health to 30 block. That's, I think, honestly, something we want, because we get 65 already, so this will be consumed instantly. We're going to reserve these two plus the bow, and we get plus 21 gold next round, and that tells me we're going to get to a subclass, which I believe they cost 10 gold to buy. So let's see what we have here. You have very little healing, but you have poison, so we're kind of against the time here. And you kind of do a lot of damage there. I think we're in trouble. Yeah, definitely. Okay. Second loss, that's okay. But we get a subclass unlocked, so we get our life back. That's okay. Okay, let's see. I believe these are the same. These are the same every time for the ranger, at least, obviously. We do have a Beastmaster. We can kind of guess what they do. They focus on pets. We have a Life Binder. Start of battle, we gain some mana and regeneration for each nature item. It's not necessarily too bad, since we do have quite a bit of those. Kind of few, I should say. Actually, we don't have that many. Oh, the food actually counts. Life Binder, mana and regeneration. That's not the region there. It's not too bad. We can, because we can afford it, we can do this and hold it over here. I mean, if we rearrange this, maybe we can get 4. That would be 4 health every 2 seconds. It doesn't really sound like a lot, but I think it's better than it sounds. 5 mana used, heal for 17 and cleanse 2 debuffs. That's also very nice, but since we're not really using any mana at the moment, it might not really be anything we are interested in. Mega Clover, chance to find unique items. Shop enter, generate 2 Lucky Clovers. See, this might be what we want. It is huge, it is mega, but this might be exactly what we want to get some clovers. I was going to go with the Hunter, because it's damage. Weapons deal plus 50% critical damage. They remove 15 block on crit, which is very nice. Item activates. This is actually also a way for us to get luck. And this doesn't take up space. The benefit of this one is that it would allow us to upgrade all our items and get luck passively. Ish. Poison Ivy. Okay, spikes gained, inflict poison. This is not where we are at. I think we're gonna try the Grove Keeper, just because I haven't personally tried the Grove Keeper before, so let's try that. Unfortunately, it doesn't count for this shop, but that's okay. Okay, so where are we at? We are buying this one for sure. We could afford the bow and arrow. We are definitely selling one of the short bows if we are buying, or when we are buying the bow and arrow. This could be a decent time for a complete redo here of this thing. You just need to be in the inventory somewhere. It doesn't really matter where. Let's see what we can do. You go up here. That's the only thing that can fit up here if we don't want to redo the bags. And if I'm honest, I would kind of avoid to redo the bags. But we might not have a choice here. You know what, let's just get everything out here. Let's see, we want this, I'm pretty sure. We want this to be in the fanny pack. That's why we had it there in the first place. That does mean that the whetstone doesn't get to activate the other one here. Let's say we get this. You now touch both the ranger's bag and the fanny pack. Where's my sword? My sword is there. You cannot reach both of these without doing this. That's okay. So you cannot get the whetstone in here and get the bonus from the sword. That's completely fair. Then I think we're doing something like that. So the sword gets the bonus damage. That's okay. But the sword gives bonus damage to both these. And maybe you go in there. Maybe you go up there. We remove this for now. Temporarily, maybe. We could chuck these two up here. Could do something like that, and also could get you out of there. Yeah, let's sell a short bow for 2. That gives us 6, exactly what we want for this one. And get you in there. So I hope this you can see how much we can fiddle with this, and until we have the absolutely perfect build. And this is probably not even close to perfect. Probably many, many ideas to what we could be doing differently here. Yeah, the problem is I was thinking to put these two stamina bags over here in a 3x3. Actually, let's try that, because that means could take the armor and put up there, get you over there. That might be better for us. Yeah, I think that means they buff each other now instead. I think that's okay. For now, let's see how this goes. We don't have too much healing, but we have a lot of block in the beginning. You see, get up to 95, and we get to heal, hopefully, they have a lot of healing as well. So this is going to be a loss, it looks like. They have a lot of health as well. Oh my god. Yeah, fatigue is not even gonna do anything. We would have lost anyway. It's okay. That is absolutely okay. 2 clovers. That's what we want to see. I would, however, love to see some bags soon. I do like the goobits. They do heal. Every X amount of item activations, or if we upgrade them, like they do all sorts of other things. I think usually they heal. I'm not 100%. The standard. This is a steel goobert, plus plus 2 damage and block. Actually, okay, they don't necessarily heal. The light gubert heals and inflicts blind. Yeah, that's all sorts of options. I love the guberts, but we are kind of sorely pressed for space at the moment. Let's get rid of the whetstone. Let's get the lucky clover in there. Upgrade this one. And maybe next turn we can do something with this. I'm not sure how exactly, but for now we'll upgrade the bow and arrow here. We have 12 gold. I don't think we're particularly interested in any of this. There's a pineapple. Yeah, that gives us spikes. We're not super interested in that at the moment. We don't have space for it in either case, so we want bags. That's exactly what we want right there. Maybe if we move this... what do we want to use the bag on, I suppose, is the question. But we do need space to get more stuff in here. Two, 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 and two. That's pretty good. Could get the other lucky clover in there, just to get more luck, because that's what we want. Could start to get you in here as well. I'm not actually sure if we drink the potion, if this is going to trigger. Might be something we can find out here. Let's see if we can dig for another bag. Ooh, a potion one. That's even better. Bought instantly. Let's get you over here. Lay you down. Do that for now. You're not really going to do anything other than give us some gold next time we enter the shop. It's the only reason you're there. We probably could fiddle around with it to make this get in there as well to get some extra 2 maximum health, but you know, it's so little that I don't really want to bother with it. Let's give this a try for now. We've lost, I think, 2 or 3 in a row now, which is not good. They have a lot of fancy items over here. We have a lot of armor. That is good. Oh, they heal a lot as well. I don't think we have the damage at the moment for this. We don't have any luck. They might be removing buffs. So they probably are. So this is another loss, looks like. Yep. A heavy loss at that. Very nice. We now have the Fortune's Grace. That's at least something. We do get another skill here. More stats. Once again, always offered in round 10. So if there's nothing else we wanted, we can always get more stats. Shielded. Shields have plus 25% chance to block. Armor's triggered 50% faster. Unfortunately, that doesn't really help us at the moment. I mean, the poison to be removed faster is nice, but it's also very, very niche. You have the Bactacular. Fanny packs give plus 20% plus 10% trigger speeds. Not sure exactly what that means. If it just yes, okay, so it's 20% instead of 10. I was unsure if trigger was another word there. Stamina sacks gives 10% base stamina regeneration, which is nice. Potion belts give plus 2 buffs when potion inside is consumed. Protective purses gives plus 15 block. Okay, the protective purse is another bag, a single tile bag that gives us block at the start of battle. We don't have any at the moment. We have stoned. Stone or stone golem dealt damage gain 45% of the damage as block. While you have block, 40% chance to resist critical hits. We don't have any stones or stone golem, but a 40% chance to resist crit is kind of nice. But it seems like we're going with the Bactacular here, to be honest. Extra speed for the fanny pack. We only have the one at the moment, but that's okay. Stamina sacks we have 2 of up here behind the armor. And potion belts are always good. Okay, well, let's go with that. We'll put you in straight away, of course. Another bow and arrow. Do we want that instead of the short bow? That's the question. What's damage-wise here? 2 to 3 versus 6 to 9. 2 to 3 is very, very low. Oh, okay. So the difference here is that with the Fortuna's Grace, we don't get any more luck. We just start with it. But with the Fortuna's Hope, you have a chance to build luck. So maybe we do kind of want to keep this one. Oh, I think we do. But now we need to upgrade it. Somehow we need to upgrade it. So we need you there. This is going to be a little bit worse the next round, but we will get to upgrade the Fortune's Hope. Still have 14 gold, so we should definitely still roll for stuff. Okay. See if we can find some potions, another fanny pack. That's actually pretty good. It's going to be difficult to use, though. I think... Maybe not. We could use it to give the Fortuna's Grace 10%, but that's also the only thing we could we do with this. Actually, we get it 20% because of the fanny pack, or because of the Bactacular. I mean, it's something. It's something. Start of battle, sure. Let's get an extra two health. Why not? Let's see. Could we actually do this any different? Three, three, two, two. Yeah, that's better. Temporarily, but it's better. Ten gold left. We should definitely re-roll. Ooh. We should get the whetstone. Oh, we have to redo this again now, don't we? Oh, this is going to be a... Okay, for a turn, we'll have... No buffs to the weapons. It's going to be difficult to get this to match afterwards. But it is what it is. Let's do something like that. We are re-rolling. Oh, we are rolling, I should say. We get another potion, which is extremely nice. Let's get that. Let's get you. So what this does is that when we consume this one, we consume the potion that it has marked. Without actually consuming it. Or we get the benefits from this one. So once we consume this one, we also heal for 12 and cleanse 4. So at the moment, we use this one instantly during the start of the battle, which makes this a bit of a waste. So let's turn them around. I'll switch them about. So we actually, when we consume this, we also lose 15 health to gain 30 block. I think that's a little bit better, at least. Another short bow we don't need. Reroll. Another backpack. Let's save that and let's see how we're gonna do this one. It's starting to look a little bit bleak. Luckily, we don't care about the spikes that he's creating. We have 6 luck. That's very nice. Looks like we're doing okay with this one. That's good. That's good. Starting to get a little bit worried there. Round one. Excellent. Get a little bit of our... What's it called? A little bit of our momentum back here. The snow cake is a unique item. Okay. Every three seconds we inflict cold, which means they trigger... our opponent trigger items slower. And if they have at least 10, we increase whatever that damage is. Poison? No, it's not poison. It's something else. and deal buy 10% and deal 10 something damage. Yeah, we don't. It's not our kind of build. Okay. You buff at the moment. That's good. What do you do? Weapon crits attack twice on the next attack. Okay, we want to do that. Honestly, I think we want to do that. Because this does more damage. So if this crit, then this one will attack twice. That's better. Yeah. Okay. I think it is also... You can go in there. Actually, it doesn't matter. So how do we do this? We... Let's put you up there for now. And let's do something like that. Let's upgrade this this little beautiful little piggy to a lucky piggy. Oh, we want this as well, of course. We didn't have that last round. That was a mistake. We need this. We can buy. Which we should. Do that. You can only touch one thing anyway, so you will. Let's get you down here then. Actually, maybe we do something like this instead. You touch one, two, two, one. Yeah. For now, that's okay, I think. We can do this instead. Yes. Okay. Might as well put you in there. Unstable recombobulator. Consume this and start items new. We are not about to reroll everything. We will reroll the shop though, and we have an impractically large greatsword, which we can see costs 5 stamina. Actually, is that a lot? That's a lot. That is a lot. Not something we want right now. We do get the protective purse though, and if you remember, we have the Bactacular, so this doesn't give 15, it gives 30. At start of battle, which is something we definitely want. Put you up there. Let's put you in here where no one cares. Let's see. We have the blood amulet. Start of battle, gain vampirism and maximum health. What do you upgrade with? Anything that matters to us. Actually, you do upgrade with the... No, you upgrade with a mega potion, don't you? Strong health potion. Yes, we have the health potion, so we first have to craft that. Then we can craft the vampiric potion. Both characters drop below 80% health. Consume this and gain 3 vampirism and heal 15 something damage. With lifesteal, 100% lifesteal. And deal something damage with 100% lifesteal. Okay. Not necessarily something we are like super interested in, but the little bit of vampirism could maybe offset some. Does cost 8 though. It's not cheap. But what are we really after at the moment? That's the question, right? I don't think you upgrade to anything. You do upgrade to something. I don't think that's something we're ever gonna see, though. This one, we need the hero sword, which is, once again, a wooden sword plus 2 whetstones. And then we need 2 gloves of haste. I think the gloves of haste is just standard item. Yes, it is. Right? Yeah. I don't see any gloves of haste here, at least. Okay. Well, that might be a lot to go for. Get another sword bow, whatever you want to call it. That might be a lot to go for right now. We'll buy it. Because why not? Get some vampirism. Let's see how this goes. You have a lot of fancy stuff. You also have the blood amulets. You're gonna go into Berserk mode at some point for sure. That's gonna be nasty. You do heal quite a bit, or maybe you yeah, it's the vampirism that makes you steal a lot. Well, this is gonna be close. Ooh, okay. I could see this going, him going quite nuts suddenly, but luckily we prevailed on that one. Okay, now we have the lucky picky. Start of battle, gain 2 luck, that's very nice. Chance-based effects of the star items are 15% more likely to trigger. Okay, we do want you in there for sure. We want you to trigger on the bow. So now it's 85% chance, which is nice. Do we have anything else? I don't think at the moment we have anything else. No. That's completely fine, I think. Then we can do something with all this schnapps down here. And I think something like that is 2, 3, 3, 2. Yeah, that's perfect. You are a little bit too low at the moment. But what we can do then is we remove this. Put these down. Put them down. And do like that. Then you hit. Yes. At some point we'll need to move this banana. We find more. What's it called? More potions. But for now, it is what it is. Okay. We do have a potion. But this inflicts poison on the enemy and ourselves. I don't think we care too much about potions. About poison, I should say. The thing is, of course, we have this one. The heavy drinking, so that could be beneficial to us to just, because not only could we poison our enemy to kill them faster, but we could also increase the trigger for this one by 25% just by having it. Okay, I'm sold. We do need a bit of, yes, exactly. We do need a bit of backspace for it though. The thing is, this is not necessarily what we're super after. See, and this is, yeah, this triggers in the beginning, so this will be, this is consumed, so this will trigger poison instantly. That's fine. Yeah. This is not necessarily the best use of a fanny pack. The question is if we are bothered to redo everything because of it. There's another potion, which would be the last potion. You reach 10 debuffs. Consume this and cleanse 10, which is honestly not bad. Something we could put below the healing potion? Lots of debuffs. Maybe we, maybe we put it above the healing potion. We heal and we cleanse a lot at the same time. That seems like a good call, right? Let's lock it or reserve it. Let's look for an opponent. We have 3 gold left. That is a lot of crap, and it's so difficult for me to see if this is going to be a winner or not. They have a lot of gemstones as well, which is this box of riches that allows for it. Seems like we are doing like okay. Now our armor is gone. That's when it's it gets interesting. Ooh, I think we were not more than a few seconds away from losing because they were doing a lot of damage. They were doing slow to us as well, blind and a bit of poison. Okay. What on earth? This is Cthulhu. Okay. Never seen that. Every 5 seconds deal something damage with 100% lifesteal and trigger a random food. Food gains death. Let's call it death. Triggers 15% faster for each death item. Okay. Well, it seems like will be very funny. Oh my god, he takes up 6 spaces. Yep, that is a lot. Items gain 5% critical hit chance for each lock. See, that is something we want. And I think we want it right in there. Right in there. Gonna start selling some luck soon. We might need to get rid of the banana here. Four potions, that's kind of beautiful. We don't need you there anymore, but where would we really put you? We have two fanny packs there. They are already affected. You are entirely in the ranger bag. And that can't really be changed if you want to hit both of these items, or both of these. Because we want the Fortuna's Great to hit the Hero Longsword as well. So I think these weapons are pretty much locked however they should be. So the fanny pack will be food based, it looks like. We can't even do that, but we can do this, and then we can move everything up, and then we can maybe what was my plan? I had a plan. Maybe move you over like that. Maybe that was the plan. To get more kind of things in here. Something like that. 2, 3, 2, 2. Yeah, that's okay, I think. Yeah, we will have to get the banana like over here. And you're still hitting all four of the potions. That's good. We would like these two in here as well, which we actually don't have room for at the moment. Obviously, the Bactacular takes precedence at the moment. 5 gold left. We could get a bag. Oh, we can't afford it, but we can if we sell a Lucky Clover. We will, because we have tons of them. Why not? Let's get you over here. Something like that, something like that, something like that. Is that gonna help a little bit? I don't think so, but it doesn't really matter. That's all good. No gold. You hit all four. I think it is as it should be. Just hovering over here to see if there's anything else that's chance-based. The food is, actually. Chance-based effects of the items are 15% more likely to trigger. Ooh, yes, the 30% chance to remove. Oh, okay. Or to gain empower. Ooh, okay. I think we want the carrot in here then. And maybe we can do something like that. No, maybe actually something like that then. Maybe something like that actually is good. Do you there? No, it's not good at all. You go over there then. 3, 2, 2, 1. Not gonna change. Okay, it is what it is. It is what it is. Yeah, okay, so that's 70% chance to get empower now. Okay, and it goes, and it triggers 20% faster because of the fanny pack, and another 20% because of 2 foods. That's pretty good. It's pretty decent, I think. Let's go with that. I'm not sure. Lives, yes, wins. We are 2 away from a complete victory here of the run. That is a lot of fire, sir. It looks like it's not gonna save you. Okay, we have 2 tries to win the last match here. Let's see if we can do that. There is the potion that I was kind of after. Now, just because we can't put it in a potion doesn't mean that we can't in the potion belt doesn't mean we shouldn't buy it. We're gonna buy it because it's on sale as well. We do need another pack for it right here, though. We can't just move this one, even if we wanted to, because this is also just the one extra space. So we could be rolling for a bag, a fanny pack. That's exactly what we wanted. Perfect. This could be upgraded with the banana, but it doesn't really matter since it's the last round. Unless we die. Unless we die. We lose the banana, of course, but that's okay. Oh, hello. Does that stack, I wonder? I don't know. There's, I guess, kind of little reason not to buy it, because we might as well give it extra. Doesn't say anything with this. Is there a crit chance somewhere? Doesn't look like it. No, that's fine. This is the one we want to crit as well, so this one attacks twice. We have 2 gold left. Are we re-rolling? Sure, let's roll for something, see what we can find. Nothing interesting there. Ah, we can actually see this little re-roll thing here changes color. So if we re-roll one more time, I think, then the price would increase. Another... Let's reserve it, because if we... Well, let's reserve this one as well, then. Not going to be able to fit anything, but let's see. Could be our last fight. And it looks like it is. Oh my god, they're getting completely wrecked. Okay, never mind. He's invulnerable. Reflected. Yeah, look at that. Okay, you know what? This could easily be something where I might try and go survival mode here. But this has already been going on for an hour, and I think this is a pretty decent look at backpack battles, if I could speak. For now, though, thank you for watching, and until next time, take care.